गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस रिज्यूम आवर फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स क्लास। इन लास्ट क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ बर्नौलीज इक्वेशन। वी हैड सीन टू एप्लीकेशंस। नंबर वन वेंचुरीमीटर, नंबर टू ऑरिफिस मीटर। दीज बोथ डिवाइसेस आर यूज टू मेजर द फ्लो थ्रू ए पाइप एंड द इक्वेशन फॉर फ्लो इज डेराइव्ड बाय यूजिंग बर्नौलीज इक्वेशन एंड कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन। Let us see one more application, very interesting application of Bernoulli's equation, that is pitot tube. In very simple form, this tube is a 90 degree form, as we are seeing in the figure. It is a simple tube bent in 90 degree right angle. It is a very simple form of the pitot tube. First let me brief what is a pitot tube and what is its use. The use of pitot tube is to measure the velocity at any point in a flowing fluid. Venturimeter and orifice meter are used to measure the flow through pipe, and this pitot tube is used to measure the velocity of flow at any particular point. Suppose we are applying this tube here, then we are able to measure the velocity at this point, at this line, at this layer of the fluid. What I have shown by arrow, this is this layer. Along this side of the pitot tube, so this tube, the measurement of flow is measured by the value of rise of fluid in the tube. Actually it is based on the Bernoulli's equation of conservation of total energy at any point of flowing fluid. So let us try to understand that how we will measure the velocity by using this pitot tube, how the conservation of energy will work here. This is the point here fluid is flowing with its natural velocity. This is the open channel and this is the simple form of the tube. As the flowing fluid will come near this mouth of this side of the tube, there the flow of fluid will stop here. As the fluid of flow will stop, so if we see here, the total energy is kinetic energy and pressure energy at point one. Let us ignore the potential energy because these both point we have taken in same level. So here total energy is kinetic energy and pressure energy. As the fluid will come here at this is struck with this point 2 at the entrance of this tube, the velocity of fluid will be 0 and the whole of the kinetic energy will convert into pressure energy. and due to increase of pressure energy here, the fluid in the tube will rise up to this level. So this rise of fluid will be happen due to conversion of this kinetic energy into pressure energy. So as we will apply Bernoulli's equation at this 2 point, we will come to the result. So let us see that what I have mentioned here. Pitot tube, a device used for measuring the velocity of flow at any point in a pipe or channel. We can use it in pipe, in channel, both. In both applications we can use the velocity at any point. In pipe we can measure, in open channel we can measure. This is the open channel what I have introduced here to make you understand about the Pitot tube. It is based on Bernoulli's principle of conservation of total fluid energy at any point in a flowing fluid. This principle reflects that if the velocity of flow at a point becomes zero, then the pressure at that point increases due to conversion of kinetic energy into pressure energy, what I have told here. A glass tube bent at right angle as shown in above figure is the simplest form of the tube. As I have told that this is the simplest form of the Pitot tube. The lower end of the right angle, which is bent to 90 degree, directed in the upstream direction as flow as shown above. So important is what we have to keep the, we will have to keep the mouth of this tube towards the upstream side, from which side flow is coming. Then the flow will come here and stop at this point, and that due to that stoppage of flow at this point, that energy will convert into pressure energy. The liquid rises up in tube due to conversion of kinetic energy of flowing fluid at that point into pressure energy. It is clear. The velocity can be measured the rise of liquid level in the tube. I mean to say that velocity can be measured by this rise of the liquid, that we will see in next page. Now let us consider two points, point 1 and point 2, in same horizontal level. And at point and 1, 2. Point 1 is far away from the tube and point 2 is just entrance of the tube. Let P1 be the pressure at point 1 and V1 is equal to V be the velocity of flow at point 1. P2 be the pressure at point 2 and V2 is equal to velocity at point 2. That will be zero, as I have told, because at that point the flow will stop. So V2 will be zero at the entrance of the tube, and H is equal to depth of the tube in the liquid. What is the H? H is the depth of tube in the liquid. And small H is a rise of liquid in the tube above the free liquid surface, as I have indicated in the figure. So let us apply Bernoulli's equation at point 1 and 2. We have P1 square by rho g, P1 by rho g, pressure head at point 1, V1 square by 2g, kinetic head at point 1 plus Z1, that is the potential head, is equal to P2 square by rho g, pressure head at point 2 plus V2 square by 2g, velocity head at point 2 plus Z2, potential head at point 2. But Z1 is equal to Z2, as point 1 and 2 are at the same horizontal level. So this 2 term will be cancelled. Now V2 is 0, as I have mentioned here. P1 by rho g is equal to h. That is the pressure head at point 1. And P2 by rho g is equal to h plus h. That is the pressure head at point 2. By putting all these values in equation 1, we get P1 by rho g is equal to capital H plus V1 square by 2g plus h plus small h plus capital H. That is the V2 by rho g plus V2 is 0. So here we get, by solving this equation, V1 is V. So we get V is equal to under root 2gh. Say this equation 4. Here h is P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g. So P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g is equal to h. Difference of pressure head at point 1 and 2, that is a small h. That is coming in this equation of velocity at that point. V is equal to under root 2gh. Because P1 by rho g is equal to h and P2 by rho g is equal to h plus h. So small h is equal to P2 by rho g by P1 by rho g. Pressure, difference of pressure head at point 2 and 1. Here I have by mistake written P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g, but it will be P2 by rho g minus P1 by rho g. That is small h. But V is equal to under root 2 gh. That is only theoretical velocity of the flow. Means the above equation 2 give us theoretical velocity of the flow. The actual velocity VACT is obtained by multiplying the theoretical velocity V with the coefficient of Peter tube CV. Just like coefficient of venturi meter is there for a venturi meter, similarly there is a coefficient of Peter tube that is called indicated by CV. So actual velocity of the flow can be measured by multiplying coefficient of velocity of Peter tube with theoretical velocity, that is under root 2gh, where h is the difference of pressure head at point 2 and 1. Here it will be P2 by rho g minus P1 by rho g, but by mistake I have written here P1 by rho g minus P2 by rho g. That we, you can correct it here. So the some conclusion I will give from the Peter tube for some more types of Peter tube I will introduce in next video. From by the value of those arrangement we can measure the velocity of flow at a point in a pipe also. So we will see in next video that.